Welcome to another exciting episode of the Business of Digital podcast, featuring your host, Matt Siltala and Dave Rohr. Hey guys, excited to be here with you on another one of these episodes of the Business of Digital podcast. We're going to have a unique one for us today. We get to talk sports, Dave. Well, not just sports.
College football. When I saw the tweet that started all this, I was like, that would be fun and an excuse for us to talk college football.
I mean, we need to talk about something sports related right now with no sports going on.
I know.
Or at least like barely starting up again. I don't know. Anyway, I think we're going to go with the title of Always Question the Data or Always Question Data.
I think yours is better.
All right. Always Question the Data. But yeah, go ahead and start us off, Dave, and let us know what prompted you to this, and we'll go from there.
I don't think this is a real Twitter account. It's theville 9640704.
Oh my gosh.
I didn't even realize that before. What kind of account is that? I mean, is that like your phone number or something?
Yeah, I don't know.
That's weird.
But I can't think that there's that many people wanting theville.
No. But what started this is, and I don't even remember how I went down a rabbit hole, but there was something about...
It's very easy for us to do that.
Yeah, I know. I don't spend that much time on Twitter these days, so the fact that I got down this rabbit hole also shocked me. But it was something about some recruit, and actually it was like some of it was from a year ago, and then people were talking about it, yada, yada. But what was interesting was just the list of people... I don't even know if the guy was going to see it, but just suggesting reasons why their school was where they should go and play football at. I was like, oh, cool. You know, they're not even, maybe some of them are alumni or just fans. They're trying to help, you know, the coaches recruit. Cool. But one thing that jumped out at me was this picture that someone really nicely made, and it'll be on the site for Louisville, talking about the most first round picks in the ACC since 2014. And it showed like Lamar Jackson and Teddy Bridgewater, a couple other guys that I kind of recognize, but those are the two biggest names.
Yeah.
And you know, unfortunately, Louisville since 2014 has more number one picks than Florida State. Not as many as Clemson, but I thought that was a really interesting number that they picked 2014. So this was in 2020. That's 6 years. Why did they pick 6 years?
It's a big gap.
You know, they didn't pick in the last decade. You know, most first-round picks in the last decade. And they only picked the ACC. They didn't compare themselves to, you know, any other conferences or schools in that state. But I was like, why would they pick 6 years? They didn't pick the last recruiting class, which would have been the last 4 years. They didn't pick the last 5 years. They didn't pick the last, you know, 10 in the last decade. We've crushed it. They picked six. So I, being nosy, also because I was curious why and how Louisville was, Florida State hasn't been that great the last couple of years. So it didn't shock me too much. But, I did find it interesting, and I went and, thanks Wikipedia, found that before 2014, Louisville had like one first round pick in like 5 years. So if I went back to 2010, I think they had one, and then they had like one in 2009 or something like that. And so I was like, oh, so if you go back a decade of drafts, they only add one more, while Clemson adds like six more and Florida State adds like four or five more. And suddenly they're not number two. So whoever created this, probably someone at Louisville, was nitpicking and picking the data that told the story they wanted. And that's really what got me to this whole thing, is so often when people present data at...
You mean
internally,
people skew data to be in their favor, Dave?
They might, if they're trying to get budget and they're trying to make, you know, their team look good or their campaign look good or their agency, you know, they're leaving out certain things. I'm sure people might do it from time to time. And this was just, and for me, it was an obvious example of why did they pick that date? That's really interesting. And oh, look, that's why.
Yeah.
Because it told the story they wanted. And if you looked back, and if you took off like 1 year and went back 5 years instead of six, again, Louisville looked not so good because they had 2 years where they had like three picks and everything else is like, you know, goose eggs.
You know, it's interesting. I'll just share with you a thought that came across while we're you know, on this. I've talked with so many people, and again, those type of people that I trust with data. We're talking like the Susan Winograds, the Annie Cushings, people like that, that have told me, or that when they have talked with other agencies or other clients, for example, where they have been shown, hey, this is like work that's been done, or this is data that's been showed to us, or this is what's been, you know, like said how, you know, proof or whatever you will that it's working. They look at it and they're just like, they instantly can see the manipulation going on. They can instantly pick that apart. I can't tell you how many times these individuals have told me like, yeah, I got this report back from work that had been done on this account for over a year, whether it be like, you know, Facebook paid ad, whatever, or just regular, you know, Google ads, whatever it might be. And just like the numbers that they're showing these clients to try to prove their worth has basically been complete BS and garbage. And that kind of stuff is happening all the time. And so just more to your point of people doing this kind of stuff and always questioning that data, it just, you have to be aware. You have to understand that that kind of stuff's going on. So I think it's good that we're talking about this.
Also, Louisville, you had all of two first round picks the entire years of 2000 to 2010. So nah, I'm looking at the Wikipedia data. And yeah, so 2014, you know, they had Calvin Pryor, Marcus Smith, Terry Bridgewater. They had three number ones that year. None, not even a single person picked in 2013, one in 2012. So yeah, whoever created this graphic clearly picked and used that data. And then, you know, nitpicked it. And here's the visual, and it's telling this story that I want to tell. I've had a couple bosses, but one that really was big on data. Every monthly report I had to create, we always had to have the data in the back. So it's like, here's the pretty charts that you can use in your quarterly, your monthly meetings with the CEO and the board. You know, here's what we can talk through in our team meetings. You know, but then he really wanted the data in back because he would then look for trends. So it's like, okay, that's great. You know, that's pretty. Who cares? You know, what are you seeing? And then he would dig into the PPC data, or he would dig into the SEO data, the rankings, traffic, and be like, okay, well, why is this section of the site doing this? And why is that? And, you know, come up with his own questions. And we did it all the time. And, you know, there was no BSing him.
Yeah.
Because he would want to look at the data himself and come up with his own questions, his own, you know, you couldn't sugarcoat it.
Well, I think the most important thing that you're trying to get across to people, and I hope that that's what they're getting from this, from listening to this, is maybe, you know, there's not some like magic thing that you could do to like prevent people from showing you data in their favor. But the point here is to do exactly what you said, Dave, and question it. Like, when you're presented something or you're given something, especially that's looking really favorable, you know, to the person that's presenting it to you, it's not that you're saying, hey, I don't trust you, I don't believe you, but it's, you're questioning that. It should probably be something that you're automatically doing, and you're not just taking their word for it. You're not just leaving your business to chance, so to speak. You're actually figuring out the truth behind that. You know, is there truth behind this data? And going from there. And I think that's kind of what you're getting at. And I think that's what people need to take away from this.
I once worked when I was in-house, we had this PPC agency and they kept quoting all of the Google conversion data, even though every single frickin' time we met with them, we would go and remind them that those numbers are complete junk. Because just because Google says that someone converted and filled out a form, if they filled out five forms, Google would count it five times.
Yeah.
We got one lead, and that was a bad lead because it was a junk because they used a fake email. So actually, those are zero. You know, and they kept going, oh, you know, our CPLs are this and da 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 da. And we're like, no, actually, it's way higher than that, and you're not even close to what we're trying to get to, because that number is not a real number. That's just, you know, make believe. And I actually use that now. I actually flip it. I have one client now where I actually pay attention to it because, and you kind of have to now, with Google, if we want to get to the point where I can turn on automation and let the AI take over some of the bidding for us, we have to watch it and understand what percentage of the conversions that it thinks are happening, that the way we're tracking stuff, and monitor that to understand how close is it to reality. Like, because that'll help us then set our CPA type bidding. So because I'm always questioning the data, I every week look at the number of conversions, quote unquote, that show up from Google Ads, and then I compare it to the funnel. How many were bad leads? How many are good leads? How many closed? How many sales did we get? How many did we lose? But at least, you know, we're moving down the pipeline. And then I compare it and go, okay, well, we had 10 conversions in Google Ads, but really only 5 leads and only one good one. Okay. You know, and then the next week, maybe it's closer, maybe it's farther away. But I have to use that data because if I want to get to the point where we can turn on certain features, we need to know the data.
Yeah. It's just all of this just makes me think of, like, if people are not paying attention to this, like, what are some sources that, like, I don't know if you have any tips for them to be able to, like, I don't know, like, what's the right word here, like, question, or, you know, like, any kind of
spend tips. Time in analytics. Spend time checklist. In your CRM.
All right. Yeah. There you go. Sorry. Go ahead.
No, I was just, I mean, that is my tip. If your agency knows your data better than you, you failed.
Yeah.
If you hire an SEO agency or a social agency or a consultant or a PPC person, and they know that data better than you, you'll never be able to win that question. You won't understand it. And if you don't understand it, they could be giving you garbage and you won't know. And so when you then take that data or those reports and you take it up to someone, or you try to, you know, say, hey, look at these wins and these successes, this campaign's been crushing it, and, you know, blah, 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 blah. And then someone else internally that does get the numbers and does see beyond whatever that little, you know, manipulated data that you're looking at is, and they basically rip you apart because you're going to them asking for budget, resources, something, and trying to give them basically junk to support yourself. I don't know if you'll always, you know, if you won't get away with it from time to time, but I have to think that there's going to be more times than not where someone's going to call you out on it. And if you don't understand how you got to that data point and you can't explain it, to me, that would be a huge red flag and go, well, if you don't know how you got this data point, how can you claim and how are you using this as, you know, to support yourself?
Yeah.
You know, if you don't know how you're getting to that average sale cost and, you know, what the average order is and, you know, how we're winning and how you're succeeding, why would I give you more budget?
Yeah.
Because really the numbers, when I look at it, show that your channel or your campaign was actually the least successful, you know, of last month, of everything we did.
Oh, geez. Yeah.
You know, but because someone manipulated the data to try to tell that story to make them look good, it's not real.
So here's the real question, Dave.
Like Google, well, like when someone uses the overall ranking data for Google Search Console.
Uh-huh.
Because it just averages everything. But it's, yeah, sorry.
No, that's fine. So here's the real question, though, that I have in all this. So how many draft picks is Florida going to have this year?
Florida or Florida State?
Sorry, Florida State.
versus
Louisville.
I don't know.
How funny. It's interesting.
We have another new coach. I don't know.
I just hope that we get sports. I just want to start watching sports again.
We had one in 2019, one in 2018. None, one, two, one. But yeah, and the other thing about that data is if they added 2013, Florida State had three number one picks in 2013, which would have put us way above them.
So again, yeah. Manipulating the data.
Well, yeah, nitpicking the data, nitpicking the years. You know, what if we just look at the last week or the last 2 weeks? Well, why don't we look at the last month? No, let's just look at the last 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Or let's look at, you know, year over year or month over month. No, let's just look at, you know, the last week versus the previous week. Well, the previous week was, you know, a holiday week, so that's going to be low. Oh, yeah, that's, yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. No, of course you did.
Yeah.
Of course they did.
Yeah. Well, any final thoughts on questioning the data, Dave?
I think know the data, spend time in it. I've talked about this before probably way too many times, but schedule 30 minutes a week to dig into your Google Analytics or, you know, Pickwick or whatever analytics solution you have. Set up another 30 minutes to dig into your Google Search Console, your Bing Search Console, webmaster stuff.
And dig into that. If you don't know any of those that he's talking about, then you need to get on them and smack your
yeah. Sorry. Spend another, you know, set up another 15, 30 minutes and dig into your own conversion data, your own CRM, and understand where leads are coming from, sales are coming from. If you're an e-tail, you know, understand what products are selling or not selling. You know, compare what's ranking well to what's not selling a lot or what's getting horrible conversions. You know, is it because you're pricing? Is it because you're meta description is outdated? Is it because, you know, it's just not what people want and it's not optimized for the right thing? You know, take a look at all that data and keep educating yourself more and more and try to be the most educated person on the data so that one, if you really want to, you can try to pull the wool over someone else's, I guess, and manipulate the data, but really so that someone can't do it to you.
Yeah.
You know, use the data for good, hopefully.
I like it. Like it a lot. So, all right, guys.
I like data.
Hopefully you understand, and at least we're going to set you on the path of starting to question and figure out your data for yourself. And I do appreciate you taking the time and going over this with us. All from a sports tweet, Dave.
Yes. So yes.
Finally got to work that in.
I know. I was like, that's a good excuse.
All right. Well, as always, guys, we would love if you're listening to us on any platform, thank you. But if you're on iTunes, definitely go and give us a 5-star rating. Take that time. It means a lot to us and definitely helps us out. So for Dave Rohr with Northside Metrics, I'm Matt Siltala with Avalanche Media. And thank you guys for joining us. We'll catch you on the next one. Bye, all.
Thanks.